This video explains a mechanical energy generation system that powers a generator using water flow, gravity, and weighted buckets, ultimately producing usable energy. Here's a detailed explanation. Tank 1. This is the lower reservoir where water is collected. Water pump. This pump takes water from tank 1 and pumps it upwards at a flow rate of 1 liter per minute. The pump consumes 5 watts of power. At the bottom, a 10-watt water pump is drawing water from water tank 1 and pumping it upward at a flow rate of 1 liter per minute. The water is transported to the top of the system at tank 2. How much energy the pump will consume? In an ideal scenario with 100% efficiency, the water pump would consume approximately 196.2 joules of energy to pump 1 liter of water to a height of 20 meters. Since the pump we are using is only 65% efficient, it will require more input power than the ideal 196.2 joules discussed earlier. In practice, the pump will consume approximately 300 joules of energy to pump 1 liter of water to a height of 20 meters, considering its 65% efficiency. Therefore, you would need a pump with a power rating of approximately 5 watts to lift 1 liter of water to a height of 20 meters in 1 minute, considering the pump's 65% efficiency. At the top, water from a tank 2 is dispensed into buckets, hanging on a vertical shaft. Each bucket is filled with 1 liter of water. The weight of the water in the bucket provides a rotational force to the shaft. As the buckets are filled, their weight causes the shaft to rotate. The rotation is transmitted to a 100-watt alternator, converting the mechanical energy into electrical energy. Once a bucket reaches the bottom, it empties its water back into the tank 1 and is pulled back up to repeat the cycle. There are 20 buckets moving in the system. Half of these buckets are always filled with 1 liter of water each, while the other half remain empty. The filled buckets constantly move downward due to gravity, exerting force on the shaft. The water-filled buckets exert a total downward force of 98.1 newtons on the shaft. After doing some calculations, we found that the shaft is theoretically producing about 14 watts of mechanical power. If the alternator has an efficiency of 80%, the electrical power produced is approximately 11.29 watts. I didn't come up with the idea in the video. I learned it from other YouTubers. I created the animation to help me understand it better and to start a discussion with people who know about it. Please let me know if you think the model is practical. Have you explored similar free energy concepts? Share your experience and knowledge with us in the comments below.